Ticket with Peter Frampton at the Odeon Sunday, May 9th.
He says it's a very strong segment. Superman trivia.
Well, you should be very good at that.
Yeah, well, he tested me on two of them, and I got them right away.
Oh, see? That I'll be out of.
Right.
No,
you'll be impressed. I'll be able to impress you. I'll be like Eddie Van Halen.
All
no,
right.
Like a great guitar virtuoso. I'll be a Superman virtuoso.
Very good.
Nancy Wilson of Hearts coming in to do a couple of tunes and say hello to us. I'm a big fan of hers.
That's exciting.
Always liked the way she looked. I didn't care about the music. I love like the way she looks.
The music was good, too. The
music was good, too. A doctor who removes implants from humans that were left by aliens will be on our show.
Now, how does...
you and we'll be back right after these words.
You're listening to Mr. Showbiz.
Watch the Savannah game with Savannah from Score. So Benji kisses High Pitch Arc, but I might have to save that for the following Saturday.
Can't fit it in.
Yeah, and more. Try and decide who's scariest, Scott the Engineer or OJ.
No contest.
Yep. Our phones are ringing off the hook about the controversy about this doctor.
Yeah, who are those two actors?
Those two actors were from Tony and Tina's wedding. They're great, great actors. They had everybody going, didn't they?
Great job.
Oh, that was so funny.
I've been planning that for weeks. That was great, right?
Oh, it was fantastic.
Yes. What is it, Kim?
I just want to say that, like, I don't understand what kind of man would look at a 9-year-old girl picture a 21-year-old. There's a word for that. It's called...
Let me tell you something. The doctor is controversial. He has written a controversial book.
Yeah.
But he says...
But you won't be able to find it.
Right. Up, the doctor is back, and so is Mary. Right.
Amazon.com.
Amazon.com. Check that book.
It's disgusting.
Doctor, how could you... This woman thinks you're disgusting. Wilson will be here from Heart. Have to have you guys back. I say we do it again. Half the people haven't realized what went on anyway.
I know. They'll be calling.
Right,
I'm digging Mary over there. Big time. Big time. It's going to fix you up with Dr. Weiss. Hey, am I painting any girls green, their breasts? I wonder.
You're going to paint Mary.
Maybe you can paint the doctor.
You'll run out of paint.
Are there any girls who want their breasts painted green?
Three girls here before, but they didn't have ID on them. They looked a little young, so we sent them home.
There you go. Thank you.
So you lost all your girls.
Well, they were young. Personally, I like that.
You had that crazy girl from Canada.
Yeah.
Yeah, at least I painted her brush. By the way, on TV tonight, the only thing that might interest you, Robin, is that the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame show will be on VH1. Which is the show you were at the other night.
Yeah, I'd like to see what they did with it now that I saw everything that happened.
Also, because you like this feature, I'll do it for you real quick. Here are the top five songs in the country. We have this all worked out.
Okay.
The number five song is Shania Twain.
Little Queen.
Right. Heart is a great group. Nancy Wilson, I guess, put out a new CD on her own without her sister.
Oh, and the rest of the band?
No, I think
or
it's
did
just...
they kick the sister out of the band?
No, I don't. I think Heart is still Heart, but Nancy Wilson is Nancy Wilson.
Oh, she's just a solo effort.
Yeah, I always had a crush on her.
Uh-oh.
What do you mean, uh-oh?
Well, when she comes in, you may not be able to keep your hands off her.
I might paint her breast green.
Oh!
Anyway, her new CD is called Live at McCabe's Guitar Shop, whatever that means.
Well, we'll find out.
Let me see.
Hi, my name is...
Real cute.
Sister!
Oh, you went to the show last night.
Yeah,
that's right.
Oh!
Forest green.
Ow! Ooh!
Rain.
I always thought it was kind of sexy, two girls, you know, who could sing and write their own music.
Had their own band.
Yeah. And then,
great voices.
Yeah, I thought it was sexy. I thought I was going to marry her, but she married Cameron Crowe.
You never got to her.
Never did. I didn't get to anybody. I was 19. Yeah, go ahead.
She'll be in 20 seconds, Howard. She's just
in the can.
The last string on her guitar.
She's what? Oh.
Tuning the last string on her guitar.
Oh, thought she was in the can.
You wanted to think of her there?
Yeah.
20 seconds.
Don't worry, Bolf. I'll get it right in a minute.
We all ready.
It's no problem, Bolf.
I'm holding the door now.
She'll be in any minute.
20 seconds.
I'm coming to an hour.
Oh, there she is. All right. Hey, baby. Come on in. Come on, I'll paint your breast green.
Yeah.
You know you want it. Nice to meet you. What are you wearing, a Superman t-shirt? You a big Superman fan? Me too. I tell you, Nancy was always like a girl who was like into guy stuff. Guitars, Superman.
Yeah, because she was the like major guitarist.
Yeah. Yeah, you said it was her sister.
No. Her sister was the singer.
No, they're both singers.
You said I was the other one. You wanted the other one.
No. I always thought it was cool that you married Cameron Crowe.
How'd that happen?
How do you get a guy like that? Actually, it was probably easy because you're a rock star.
Well, he used to write for Rolling Stone, so you knew him from there.
He's a rock journalist.
Yeah.
So what happened? He came and interviewed you one day for Rolling Stone?
I paid him. I paid him for a good review. I gave him some money.
No, come on. Be honest. What happened? He came to interview you?
Actually,
instead he came on.
A mutual friend of ours introduced us. It was a matchmaking kind of deal.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, that's a good match.
Who matches you to...
He's my manager now.
Is he really?
Kelly Curtis. You know Kelly?
No.
He's one of my oldest friends in the whole world.
Wow. How would I know him?
Well, Pearl Jam's manager.
Oh, really? I still don't know him.
Still don't know
him. I don't know any of these guys. We don't even know Pearl Jam.
Well, I was trying to get him to come on with me.
Let me understand something, because you probably had a lot of guys who came on to you being in Heart.
Yeah.
And then you probably didn't trust any men.
No.
So why did you trust Cameron?
Because he was introduced to her by somebody.
Yeah.
Well,
see, that's how it works.
But you know these things. You know, it's an instinctive thing.
Well, did you go through a wild period where you banged a lot of different guys?
No, actually.
No. I would have liked to have been on that gravy train.
Standing in that line, huh?
Yeah, why not?
Gravy train.
Yes, I'm standing here. This is the line where you bang Nancy Wilson.
How old were you when you got married?
Behind door number three.
Had you gone through a lot of, like, different guys before
They've
you got
been
married?
Around for quite
actually,
a while.
No, I mean, I got wild in other ways, but I didn't get wild in that kind of way.
What'd you do, like drugs and stuff?
Yeah, I had my drug phase.
Would you do heroin?
No.
I thought part of the drug thing was to do a lot of sex,
but, you know,
too.
Why would you be on drugs and not have sex? I don't get it.
That's the whole reason.
So what do you mean? You were wild?
That's the way it happens in the movies.
No, but I mean, what kind of drugs are you doing? Coke?
Well, early on, it was like acid and, you know, the mind-expanding drugs.
Did you like acid?
I did.
You did? I didn't like it. It made me very paranoid, and it was too many hallucinations.
But you probably were with the wrong people.
I wasn't with anybody. I was alone.
You took too much.
Yeah, that was stupid.
Well, no wonder. You had to be inside your own head.
Yeah, and that's a pretty scary place to be. No, I really don't want to.
Yeah,
you know what?
That's why he's the way he is today.
No, but if you had the right music... In, you know, the right place, the right music, and
well,
the right friend.
Well, how did they get all that together? You don't want to get high.
I was a poor college student.
You have to plan ahead for these things.
No, my friend saw I was tripping and I was bumming out, so he put on, I remember, he put the Grateful Dead on, thinking that I would like that, and I bummed out.
Yeah.
I was like, what am I, in like a drug movie? And then he put like Day in the Life on from the Beatles.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh. You know, give
but
me some...
give him a list of the right music.
What is the right music to do when you're on acid?
Well... During those days, it was stuff like the Moody Blues, you know, because it was like the extra plane.
It would freak me out. I took too much. You know what? When I did mescaline.
Did you take too much?
When I did mescaline and stuff, that was fine.
Yeah.
And then I went and took this acid, and I took a four-way hit myself. And that's four hits. So that's what screwed me up.
Why did you do that, Howard?
I didn't know what I was doing. There was no directions
on
the...
there were never any instructions.
There was no directions.
No directions on
they don't give you directions when you do it, and it was a really... It was a horrible experience.
Were you
warning.
Alone when you did it, or you just...
Well, some friends dragged me around, but they were not high. I was. And then the only other time I did it was when I went to watch 2001 A Space Odyssey.
Yeah.
And I still didn't understand
it.
I did that
once,
too.
You did that, too?
Yeah,
I just stared at the ceiling.
John Lennon did that. Didn't you hear that story?
No.
John Lennon had seen that movie like 18 times on acid.
Did you understand it?
Do that too.
And you did that, too. So you were wild, but you didn't have wild sex.
No, because I was very romantic.
You were.
Did Anne have sex? Did anybody have sex?
It's a sexy kind of show here, isn't it? It's very sexy.
So you meet Cameron on a blind date or something?
Yeah, like we were supposed to meet, but we didn't meet.
But he knew you because you're so famous.
Well, he knew of us, yeah.
And at that point, he was a nebbish. I mean, nobody had heard of him except he was a Rolling Stone writer.
He was this, you know, little kind of wunderkind, sort of semi-nerdy.
Did he write Fast Times at that point?
He had just written Fast Times, the book, and
they
were developing it for the movie.
Right.
So he was like the starving writer guy, and I was like the rock star.
Did you make him sign a prenuptial agreement?
No.
You did not?
No, everybody.
You had millions and millions of dollars from Hart. I mean, you were set for life. Weren't you nervous that this journalist would marry you and then take half of your money?
No.
I'm shocked.
No, because...
He hit the lottery.
She did, too.
No, well, later on.
But then later I went broke and he got rich.
Right.
Did you go broke?
Well, for a while, and then that kind of made it all
better. After you married him, you went broke?
Yeah, I was real estate challenged there.
I would be really pissed if I married Nancy Wilson from Hart.
You were in the money.
And then she was broke.
Oh,
I would be furious.
What's up with this?
Yeah, wait a minute.
Did you go broke from all the drugs and stuff?
Oh no.
I mean, acid's not that expensive. I'm always shocked when I hear rock stars say they went bankrupt on drugs.
No,
I'm like,
I bought too many homes. I was like, I gotta have a house. Then the fans would find me.
Right.
Buy another house, couldn't sell the first house, the fans would find me again.
Right.
Buy a lake house, they can't find me hidden out on a lake.
How many homes did you own?
Then they're coming by in their speedboats, and they're like looking in binoculars in my front window on their boats.
Right, so that bothered you.
So, you know, I moved like three times. I had like three houses I could not sell.
Right.
So.
Wait a second, though. And Hart.
What kind of houses could these be?
Hart toured.
I gave my mom and dad a house. And then there was a beach house, too.
Really? Because you must have made millions.
I had way too many houses.
But you had millions and millions of dollars.
But these houses must have each cost $25 million or something.
I had a couple $3 million there for a while. Then.
Three?
Couple three.
Yeah, you had more than a couple three. I mean, seriously, Hart was a big band.
No, she's talking about the houses being worth three.
Yeah. Oh, okay, whatever, but still.
Oh, well, no.
So you got,
$9
million in real estate.
Mm-hmm.
Record company takes all of it, though.
They do?
Yeah.
Well,
and management.
How does that happen?
Well, I don't know. They wear suits and...
And you just give them your money?
That makes me nuts.
They wear the suits.
So then you start going out on dates with Cameron.
So he was like, he was too shy to come meet me, because the band was all there expecting for us to meet. It was like all this pressure was put on.
Yeah, and by the way, Cameron's the guy who just did Jerry Maguire and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So like now he's rolling. Who's richer at this point? Seriously, do you know?
Right now?
Yeah. Is he more?
Yeah, I think he's much.
He has more wealth.
Yeah.
So you married well. That's good. I like that.
I guess we're like a power couple.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're kind of like a power couple.
I don't know if
I want to be in a power couple, but I think we are a power couple.
Let me take a couple of phone calls here, see if... Hi, Carl, you're on the air.
Hello, Howard?
Yes.
I just want to know who this girl is here that you're talking to, because I'd never heard of her.
You never heard of Hart?
No.
Black jazz singer, remember?
You never heard of Hart? How old are you?
18.
Oh.
Ooh.
You never hear, Crazy on You?
No.
You never heard of that?
Dreamboat Annie?
I'm a magic man.
Ooh, Barracuda.
Ooh, Barracuda. You never heard of that?
No.
Oh.
God.
You play something. He's heard this music. He just doesn't know he's...
Wait, I'll play him something. He, of course he knows.
Well, if he's 18, come on.
Yeah, but
your
records are played all the time. It's not like you're some obscure artist.
Maybe he's a hip-hop kind of boy.
All right. Right,
no, not at all.
Here, listen to this.
All right.
You never heard this. You don't know this?
Cold late nights alone.
You don't know that?
No.
Wow.
All right, try something else.
Oh, please. What, do I got to give him an education? Well, you're going to do a couple of your tunes, right?
It's not like I'm not the only one. I got my friend here. He doesn't know the music either.
Well, what do you know? I know very little.
I'm just heartbroken. There's someone out there.
But you probably don't even know, like, the Beatles or something.
Well, at least you can live in a house now.
Like, you know the Beatles?
Yeah.
What about Zeppelin?
Yeah, I know some Zeppelin.
Really?
You know Jimi Hendrix?
Yeah.
And you never heard Hart?
Never heard Hart.
You know Bonnie Raitt?
No.
Oh, please.
Stop it.
Please.
He's never heard of the women.
Bonnie Raitt.
You know Pat Benatar?
There's this new thing. It's called the opposite sex.
Yeah, well, come on. You guys are famous.
Yeah, this guy's never seen a woman. What are you talking
about? Go ahead, Pete. What's up?
Yeah, I was wondering. I want to know if there's any truth to the rumor that those two used to record naked when they did Hart.
Did you and your sister record naked when you did some of the Hart stuff?
No, that was Susanna Hoffs.
She recorded naked, right?
Yes, she did.
You guys never played Hide the Microphone?
Oh, man, that's absurd.
Played what?
Hide the Microphone.
Oh, yeah, rickety.
Bill, you're on the air.
Yeah, hi. Good morning, Ms. Wilson.
Good morning to you.
Considering you're on the Howard Stern Show, let's see if we can cause a little bit of havoc for you.
Okay.
About 1978, your A&R guy released something that said, first of all, that you were lesbian sisters, correct?
That is correct.
Oh, that's hot. I didn't know that.
Your A&R guy did that.
Really?
You didn't know that.
Did your lesbian sisters? I didn't know you guys were lesbians. Wow. That's hot. Cool. I didn't know you two did each other.
Sexy.
Is that true you guys were lesbians?
That's a sexy.
Is that true?
No.
Oh, it's not.
But that was the marketing guys.
Oh.
Yeah.
You know.
You never tried any lesbianism?
I kind of wish I had. I mean,
really?
It would have been a lot more exciting than
that. I'll try it with you. I'm hung like a girl.
We could be lesbians together.
We could be lesbians together.
And one more thing, Howard.
Yes.
If I'm correct, let's see how well my memory serves me.
Well, so far your memory hasn't done us any good.
Oh, well, yes, it does. You found out the A&R guy released something that said they were lesbians.
All right, but it wasn't true.
Excuse me?
But it wasn't true.
No. It wasn't true that they were lesbians, but it was true that it was released.
Okay.
All right, whatever.
Who cares? Well, that is historic fact.
All right, so what else do you want to say, real quick?
All right, and there was also something where they did one song to insinuate that as well. Is that correct, Miss Wilson?
What is she, on the witness stand?
Jesus.
Well, let's see now. What song are you referring to, sir?
Oh, well, I'd rather not say.
You mean that song title? Could you give me a title? Because
why would you rather not say?
Because he's an idiot. Yeah. Joe, go ahead.
I'm trying to figure out what you're talking
about. Howard.
Yeah.
Howard.
I like your hair color.
Why, thank you.
Yeah, it's nice.
I kind of felt kind of like a tomato one day. So
yeah, it's all red.
It's red now.
You got a nice profile.
Howard.
Anybody ever tell you that?
No.
No, I'm telling you. Hey, believe me, I know.
Howard, I like yours too.
No, you don't. All right, go ahead. You're on the air.
Howard.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hello, what?
Howard.
What do you want?
God,
Howard,
man.
Yes.
Howard, remember that video? These dreams?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's the blonde one, right?
Yeah.
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 The other one.
Remember the boobs used to spill out of that?
Yes, I do. Very sexy woman. There's no question.
I used to pleasure myself to her all the time.
Really?
I used to love that video.
Yes.
Did you ever pause it?
Oh, please. Of course. Everybody did.
Oh, is that what you do?
I used to think about you a lot.
Is that how it all works?
I used to think about you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to think when I first started, like, you know, listening to Heart. Maybe I was in college or something.
Uh-huh.
You two used to be up there and everything, and I think about having sex with you. Sure, why not?
Heart was a sexy, sexy rock band.
It was. Good rock band, too.
Pretty good band, eh?
Yeah, I'll say.
Well, at least we're still here, so.
Yeah, I remember one time I was watching on TV, I had Kleenex. A box of Kleenex by the TV. Right, Robin? I told you about that.
I wasn't there. Don't ask me.
Weren't you back there with me? Yeah, I remember my parents were real mad because I messed up the TV set.
That's right.
It didn't work for a while.
They started yelling.
So, how long does Cameron Crowe have to date you before he got into your pants? Like, did you make him wait
like,
a long time?
Did you
time?
Fall in love? Was it love at first sight? Or
Well,
Cameron's not a great-looking guy.
I don't know what he looks like.
He's a sexy, sexy man.
No, he's not. He's a sexy man because he's
Take
Cameron.
Take it from me. I married the guy.
No, but he's not.
Who's going to know how sexy Cameron is?
Yeah, but he's not a great-looking guy. He's like me. He's not a great-looking guy.
Come on.
I'm a three. Okay, he's maybe. Like a three.
Well, you see, I'm not one of these, you know, what's his name,
You're not into models and stuff.
Yeah, that kind of stuff really is really not
You're into a guy's mind.
It's not my thing.
Yeah, there's so few broads like you.
Well,
trust
wait a minute.
I'm into the more intellectual,
took,
interesting guys.
All right, so you go out on a date. You get set up on a blind date with the great writer Cameron Crowe.
We kind of dated for a few months before we actually kind of had our night together, you know.
Really?
Actually,
a few months?
Yeah.
Why? Because you're so mistrustful when you're a rock star?
Are you on the road or something?
No, because it was more kind of like, you know, you just don't want to be kind of typical about it and just go, hey, let's go, you know.
Well, you're uptight.
Because
I would have thought you were much looser sexually.
Yeah, rock and roll would lead you to believe that.
I mean,
I don't know. There's something to be said for the, you know, kind of the restraint thing.
Oh, please.
Not
months?
Much,
really months?
That's a long time.
Well, you know,
months.
You're hot, but I don't know if I could wait months.
You know, you kind of build that excitement up.
Right.
And then, you know, you kind of go on these dates and something.
What's a girl's mind? How can a girl wait a month? What is with you guys with your private parts? I mean, I couldn't wait an hour.
Of course you could wait.
I met my wife the first night, I got to third base.
You were 12 years old as well.
I was 19.
Well, we got
but
pretty far.
She was older then.
You were kissing him and stuff on the first date?
Well, yeah, you know.
Wow.
Well,
oh, you did
the
kiss
first
him.
Date.
Like, how many dates before he even kisses you?
Probably, like, I don't know, five.
Oh, my God.
Boy, kiss. I wouldn't even call those dates. Those were meetings.
But, you know, we were, like, working into it, towards it.
Where did he take you on the first date? To dinner or something?
Disneyland.
We went to a movie.
And how cool is that? Hey, I'm taking Nancy Wilson to a movie.
A movie.
That's probably why you made him wait. Because
we
like,
went and saw For Your Eyes Only.
Don't you think? Oh, that was the first movie you saw?
The Bond movie.
First movie I saw with my wife was Lenny Bruce.
Really?
Yes.
You know, your movie was awesome. I loved it.
Thank you.
I did.
I called Cameron about it, but he was too busy to get involved.
I know. He told me about that.
Yeah.
He cannot believe that I'm meeting you before he meets you.
Yeah, I know. But Cameron listens all the time.
I know. He's been a fan for a long time.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah, he's a nice guy.
He's the guy's like, was listening. I get up in the morning, come downstairs. He's listening to your show.
Where is he now?
Off as soon as I walk in the kitchen.
Do you get upset when he makes a movie and like he puts a hot chick like Renee Zellweger in it? Are you always afraid that he might take off with her?
Are you afraid he'll run off with somebody on the
set? I mean, you know, if you love somebody, you can't help but kind of those things run through your mind.
Right. So do you?
There's these much younger, really amazingly beautiful actresses that he's working with.
Do you go down to the set and say, hey, what the hell's going on here?
Yeah, I say, clear aside, move aside.
No, but come on.
My man.
Seriously, don't you get nervous?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, seriously.
So what do you do?
You know, I kind of go, well, don't let anybody like you, okay?
Do you keep his balls on a leash? I mean, you keep a tight leash?
No, they're in her purse.
So the guy waits five dates to kiss you.
Right.
Then he kisses you.
We took, like, road trips, and we went up to Malibu, and, we, you know, we went
And you weren't doing anything?
On the beach, and we were holding hands, and we were walking around, and we were
Could
hugging.
Could you, like, go on a trip with somebody in that hotel room?
We were kissing, and then we were hugging, and, you know, it just...
How long before he fills you up?
Gradually. Yeah. Oh, pretty quick. I mean...
Were you nervous because you said, hey, this guy just wants a bang... You know, a star.
No, because I could tell immediately he wasn't that type of a guy. Although all guys do, obviously. But,
right.
You know, he wasn't the type of guy who would just make it only about that.
And you would go away with him and have what, separate hotel rooms?
Well, no, I would come to L.A. I was like we live in Seattle most of the time.
Right.
I would make all these excuses to come to L.A. Like, okay, I've got these home movies on.
No, but you said you went away on trips with him. And all you were doing is kissing. And when you would go on these trips, you would get separate
road
hotel
trips,
rooms?
Though, like road trips where we'd like drive up the coast.
Oh, I see.
So it was just like for the day or something.
You would never stay overnight.
I would think of reasons to fly to L.A. to you know. Oh, let's see, I got to transfer my Super 8 to video, and the only city in the world where I could do that is in L.A.
I see. So you wanted excuses to meet with him.
Always like meeting up with him.
And so he waited months, and then you finally had sex.
And you know when that was? It was the night that Charles and Diana were married. It was the royal wedding.
It was that night.
Wow.
Yes.
I remember where we were, Robin.
Yeah, it was on the air.
We were in
like
Washington, D.C., and I was fat as a cow.
Oh.
Right.
What were you doing that night?
Probably sitting at home playing video games and eating.
Eating.
Yeah, eating because we were so nervous about our jobs.
Well, we had the most amazing, cool night.
Quite frankly, I was in Washington playing your records.
That's right.
That's right.
All right.
Yeah. So you had an amazing, cool night. Why was that amazing? What, did he feed you a special food or of some kind? Did you say ahead of time that you would bang him? Or did he know that was the night he was going to get you? Or was it spontaneous?
It was spontaneous, but
it was.
No. It was kind of like, we knew. It wasn't even like... Let's make love, okay?
Right.
Okay. You know, let's... Uh-huh. It wasn't decided on. But
I see. And he wore a rubber?
No.
How he did not.
Wow.
Outrageous.
You know, that was before.
Really? So he wore no rubber?
We've been together almost 18 years.
I know. Before. That's a very successful relationship.
That was before all that stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that night, how many times did you do it?
All night long.
All night long.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
And well, I made a tape of it for you, right?
Here it is. Here is the tape.
Wow.
Wow. All right. Sue,
now,
you're...
said he turns off the radio when you come in. Don't you listen to the show?
Oh. We have that joke. It's he thinks I... In the morning, you know, like in the morning, it's like, it's too early for Howard Stern.
Really?
So he thinks that... I don't want to hear Howard Stern in the morning.
I see.
So when I come downstairs, he's like, oh.
And he turns it off. Well, it's a guy thing. Guys like to listen to it.
It's kind of our joke. It's like, no, you don't have to turn off Howard Stern. You can listen to Howard Stern.
Sue, you're on the air.
Good morning. How are you?
All right.
I just want to say hi to Nancy, and that I really, really, I've been a fan of her since I was 16, and I'm now 39.
Yay.
And I've went to see them many, many times here in Philadelphia. And hi, Robin.
Hi.
What's your favorite song?
Probably Magic Man, or, you know.
So can we do a little of that acoustically? Can I call out some songs? Like, it'll be like the Mike Douglas show. I'll call out some songs and you can do a little of them.
Do a little bit
like
of...
Segway.
Kind can we do some of those?
Sure.
No, not you. I don't want you singing them.
Can you do it?
Well, let's see, though. Are you mic'd properly?
Probably.
Let me see. Let me hear you strum that thing.
You're awesome, Nancy.
Thank you.
Can you hear that?
She needs a guitar in front of the mic and one in front of her face.
Gary, come in here and help Nancy with the microphones.
Let's see.
Oh, you're doing it yourself.
We can get this going.
All right, good.
Baba booey.
Baba booey. Yeah. I like that, yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
Baba booey!
Baba booey.
How about...
There you go.
Baba-booey.
What happened? Where's the singing part? Do a little of the singing. Come on.
Oh, wait. You said Magic Man?
I don't know. I don't care which one you do.
Let's see. You know, Anne sings most of these songs.
Oh, she does?
I'm kind of
so you don't do them?
I'm kind of winging this here.
Cool late night so long ago when I was not so strong.
That's so cute when a chick's doing that. Ooh. I can see why Cameron digs you. Yeah, that's hot.
You know, I've never played that acoustic.
I dig that.
Before. Wow.
You know, that has an effect
cool,
on me.
Cool, man.
Yeah, I like that.
See, you learn things
now,
when
do
you come
you,
on the house.
Why didn't
this
she...
is your fantasy. You've always said, I would love to have a girl who could sing, to me.
Yeah, well, after I bang her, she could sing to me.
Now, does that ever happen?
Did you ever sing to Cameron after you bang him?
After
did you ever write? Did you ever write a song about him?
Yes, I did.
What song did you write?
Well, it's not a very well-known song. It's a new song that hasn't been put on an album yet.
18 years and you finally wrote a song.
Wow. Yeah. Mm. 18 years later.
And what is it? Is it like all mushy and stuff?
Oh, it's real mushy.
Like, what are the lyrics?
It's kind of like, you know, I can read your eyes, baby.
Wow.
You know, it's stuff
you're
like,
into it.
Right into your mind, baby. Yeah. You know, stuff like that.
Wow.
You know.
So you're telling me the first night you had sex with Cameron, he banged you all night? Like he did it a couple of times?
Like, what does that mean?
Like, how many times did
talking
you...
Talking about our first night together.
How many times did you have sex with him?
Oh, God, you know, it was one of those, you know, like...
Just an all-nighter.
Come on, you know,
wow.
When you first get with somebody, isn't that kind of how it goes?
Is he good at oral? Was it the first time he did that to you?
Sexy man.
You like that, right? You enjoy that.
Sexy man.
He is a sexy man. All right, well, that's good. Want to adopt?
Oh, yes, they will.
I'm sure they wouldn't give you any, right?
Well, you've already got.
Well, I keep applying for white children, so they won't.
Yeah. They won't give them to you. They won't allow it. Yeah, John, go ahead. All right, let's play something else. What else you got there? Let's see. What about Crazy on You? No. Wait, let me think. What about Love? Something like that?
Or let's see. What about Love? About
did you tell her you did a parody? Did you know
dreams?
There's a parody?
I do a song to What About Love, me and Fred.
You do?
It's called What About Gloves. We wrote it years ago.
Don't you want some gloves to go with those shoes?
No, it was What About Gloves. Like when AIDS first came around, Fred and I were gay. Did you ever hear it?
No.
You never heard it? I want to play it for you.
Yeah, would you?
All right, I'll play it for you, sure.
Cool.
All right, play it, Fred. I always thought it was, we used to perform this live.
Yeah. You have a band, too.
Yeah.
Now, what's your band called?
The Losers. No, but this was years ago. Fred and I did a duet.
I've been worried.
Oh, yeah.
brand new virus.
Brand new virus.
Brand new one, and it was coming after me.
What about gloves? Do you really want to kiss that thing? What about gloves?
Beautiful. That is a great song.
How did I never hear that?
Yeah, how did you never hear What About Gloves?
Now, did you release that on a small label?
Oh, yes, very small. No, no, we never released it. We just...
But they used to sing it live every once in a while.
If I released it, I would have to come to you and get permission, and I'm sure you wouldn't have given it to me. So what... you would have.
We weren't the actual songwriters of that song.
Do a little of that song.
Jeez, I don't know if I could.
I should do it with you. I wish I knew the lyrics.
You know,
I just know What About Gloves.
You know, I don't know it on the guitar. That was a keyboard-heavy song.
Oh, is that right?
You know,
who wrote that? You wrote that?
No, no. We just sang that. Ann sang that.
Who wrote it?
The Canadian... forget his name.
I don't even know. Wow.
His name. It's one of those things like, on the spot!
Who wrote Crazy on You?
Well, we wrote those.
You wrote that?
All that stuff. We wrote everything up until kind of the...
Do a little of that.
Now, do you guys write together? How does that work?
Yeah, we write together. We have a couple of collaborators that we work
but do
with.
You, what, who does the music, who does the lyrics? Is there a...
Both. We kind of approach it every which way.
Yeah.
You know, to keep, you know, it's like...
Do a little of that.
Okay, I'll do that.
Quit talking so much and sing.
Oh. Just shut up.
Yeah, right, just shut up and play. Come on. Guitar real good. What did you start playing real young?
Yeah, I was about 9.
How'd you know to do that?
You guys were inspired by like Led Zeppelin and stuff like
right.
that?
Beatles, Zeppelin. When the Beatles were on Ed Sullivan, it was like the moon landing.
And no girls ever got inspired and started playing rock guitar. It was just...
Except Ann and Nancy.
That's right.
We wanted to be the Beatles, you know?
Yeah.
We didn't want to marry them. We wanted to be them.
I like that. Me and Robin want to be the Beatles, too. We just don't play any instruments.
Okay, how are we going to be John? Who gets
we have to get a band together. All right, so your new CD is live at McCabe's Guitar Shop. Is it actually a live album?
It was live. I wasn't even intending on ever releasing it, but it sort of came out that way. It's like, you got to release that.
So. And you're appearing at the, what is this, the Govinda Gallery on Tuesday, March 23rd, 1999.
Where's that?
That's right.
That's next Tuesday.
But where is the Govinda Gallery?
I never heard of it. Where is that? In New York?
Wait, no.
Oh.
It says right there.
Oh, at 7:30 p.m. featuring photographs by Neal Preston. Oh, it's in Washington, D.C.
Yeah, D.C.
The Govinda Gallery at 1227 34th Street, N.W.
You know Neal Preston? You know Neal Preston?
No.
He's the rock photographer that took all those cool, like, early Zeppelin photos with... when Cameron was the rock journalist at, like, age 15.
So are you playing there, or are you just going to be standing around?
I'm going to play
there, too. Oh, you're going
to play? Yeah.
Oh, you are?
But he was Cameron's roommate.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And I stole Cameron away from Neal Preston.
Right, he probably wanted him.
Oh!
And
they
tonight...
were lesbian... No, they were gay lovers. Yeah, that's it.
No, they weren't. Tonight, playing at Pearl Street downstairs in Northampton, Massachusetts. So you gotta fly to Massachusetts tonight.
I'm taking the train, actually.
Thursday, why? You're afraid to fly?
No, just gonna go by ground whenever possible.
Really? You're afraid?
No, I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Why would you take a long train ride and not take a plane?
Train rides aren't that long.
It's about the same length.
Yeah. Really?
I mean, if you, it's going to take the same amount of time.
You, when you consider going to the airport, getting on the plane, and all that stuff.
Breathe all that canned air and stuff.
What is it, Rick?
Hey, hi, good morning.
Hey.
Good morning.
I remember growing up, there was a lot of talk about Nancy being involved with the Charles Manson family.
Were you involved with the Charles Manson family at all?
Oh, my God, that
Come on,
stupid
Nancy.
Rumor.
You were
Come
not
on.
Oh, my God.
She's one of the kids.
This rumor will never, ever die. I can't believe it. It's
bull.
Yeah, it's total bull.
You never
knew Charlie Manson.
It's
what
horse.
About this song, Magic Man?
What is Magic Man about?
Well, Magic Man was about Ann's boyfriend at the time.
Well, he must have been good in bed.
Wow.
He was Magic Man.
Yeah. Where's that guy?
Mm.
He was the brother of the guy I was going out
he
with.
He said he broke Manson, and Manson told that he broke Hoss.
What? Hello?
Oh.
What did he just say?
I don't know.
Something.
What did you just say? Sir?
Yeah.
What did you just say?
Oh, I didn't know we're on.
Yeah, we're on.
I was reminiscing. My friend was on a conference call.
Yeah, oh.
That we were told that. You were just listening now and something about Charles Manson. We remember hearing the same thing.
All right, so what do you want to say?
Just want to say hi. Say
hi,
banged Hart.
You banged Hart?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
When did you do that?
When did you do that?
1977.
You had sex with the both sisters?
Yeah.
Did you girls ever share a guy?
No.
Well, kind of.
You had both of them?
Yeah. My friend and I.
This they don't know it.
Russ.
This is Al Gore, by the way.
I was there.
Russ, you had them too?
Yes, I did.
Who did you have?
Both
and they've got a documentary to prove it.
Well, maybe it's true. You don't know.
Yeah.
Listen, that's private.
You never went after the
same guy. Of course,
you
never believe me.
Busy girl.
But, you know, that's odd.
You believe them.
They spend a lot of time together. You never like the same guy?
No. Well, we're 4 years apart.
Uh-huh.
And we have different taste in guys, you know?
Really?
I've never been with a fan, you know what I mean?
Really?
No.
Well, you don't think Cameron was a fan, please?
Well,
rock reporter.
No, come on.
Oh, come on.
Well, I mean, fan in the...
You know how many times behind your back you just went around to his friends
groupie.
And said, guess who I'm banging?
I mean, like, groupie type fan.
Ever do a black guy?
No.
Never.
Did you?
Interesting. No, I've never done a black guy yet. I'm working toward it.
Are you working up to that?
Yeah, I'm working up to it. I want to have that. I want that in my arsenal.
Okay, I'm holding you to it.
Before you're through, you're going to have that.
Now, what about what are these new songs? What is this all about now?
I was just at this guitar shop, and they said, hey, come play in our back room sometime.
Let me hear a little of this. Play me one of the songs you like from your new record.
Well, maybe I'll do,
what?
Like a whole song?
Well, yeah. What is it called? What is this song called?
There's one called Everything that the people kind of seem to like.
Everything? What is this about?
It's one of those songs where you wanted to try to fit everything into it. But, you know, I got everything to say.
Everything?
Yeah.
All right, let me hear that.
Well, it has been forever. I've been meaning to write this letter. Tell everything to you. But everything gets in the way, just running around from day to day, thinking of things I got to say to you. And the stars just won't stand still. They fall into my eyes. I'm blind. A rhyming scheme and a drum machine and live animals are in my bed. Everything my desire is to die where the ocean meets the fire. Everything.
like city wings and the little things and the revolutionary act of love. Everything my desire is to die where the ocean meets the fire.
I'm chubbed up. I couldn't wait 5 months for you. I would have to have you right away.
Now, you guys never get recognized
sexy,
by the...
Sexy man.
No, he's not. No woman of mine would wait 5 months.
Oh, please.
For sex.
Please,
let me tell you. You...
Please.
Oh, please.
What is that thing that... What is that... What do they call that tantric yoga?
Oh, please. I hold out almost a whole minute.
But you guys never... You've never been nominated for a Grammy, have you?
Yeah, once a long time ago.
But you never won one.
No.
That's so ridiculous.
It's weird, you know, there's...
I was watching your mouth, envision you giving me oral sex during that song.
Oh,
isn't that... That's what I do during
You're
songs.
Sick.
Isn't that sick?
Join the club.
Wow. Right? Were you doing that, too?
That's why they pay you all the big bucks.
Yeah, because I'm like, you know, it'd be really cool if Nancy was giving me oral sex.
While she sings.
But that's why you get paid the huge, huge, big, fat...
I mean, isn't that sick? Like, I'm digging the song and I'm going, look at that mouth.
But of course that's what you do.
That's what you do.
It's just a lip gloss. It's a lip gloss.
It's working.
Yeah.
I swear to God it is.
Whatever it is.
It's unbelievable. Yes, you're on the air. Go ahead. Couple more phone calls, please. Humor us. You're on with Nancy Wilson. Go ahead. Yes. Hello. Go ahead.
I'm just calling Nancy because she sounds like she's a real person, and she sounds like... Hey. I wanted to know, because I'm a big fan of Janis Joplin and also of Heart.
You are a sick woman.
What do you want to...
You have nothing to say.
Well, thank you for
saying that. Yes, I have plenty to say.
Well, what do you want to say?
Stop drinking.
I'm just saying.
You should stop drinking.
I can't. She's that big a fan of Janis.
How much have you had to drink?
I saw a copper.
How much have you had to drink today?
Well, it's St. Patrick's Day now.
Yeah. Are you Irish?
Yes, I am.
And you've been drinking, haven't you?
It don't really matter.
Oh, sure it does.
No matter what day it is.
We want to know what we're dealing with.
As long as it's green, it's okay.
I've been drinking since I was 4 o'clock.
No, I just wanted to know if she got into Janis.
Everybody's into... You know, I never liked Janis Joplin.
Janis was
well,
cool.
I love her.
No, I don't think so. I don't think her songs were that good.
She was cool.
And she screeched a lot.
Expressed emotion.
It was noise.
You know...
And Big Brother and the Holding Company were a bunch of loudmouths.
Oh, yeah, right.
I don't think they were the best band in the world, but
they
she
were not.
Had a lot of soul.
Yeah. You think?
Yeah,
a lot of soul.
Her voice annoyed me.
In a way, it was so toxic, in a way that it was hard to, you know.
Yeah, I mean, she sang it all. It was all in there.
It
right.
From her
I'll admit it, you
she
didn't like her. I bet you didn't listen to her. You listened to Zeppelin and stuff. Did your parents think you were, seriously, did your parents think you were, like, gay because you played guitar and, like, were doing boy
gay?
Things? Yes.
Well, that's even, you know.
You know what I mean? Seriously, because it was like a masculine thing to be in a rock band.
Well, there weren't any girl bands.
You know. But, you know, there was the acoustic guitar, you know, which was more like the folk.
Joni Mitchell kind of thing.
Joni Mitchell, Joan Baez, you know.
Yeah. I like your new song. It's very good.
Oh, thank you.
Very, very nice.
Very, very nice. Now, you have a band, don't you?
Yes, I do. The Losers.
You should really? Why didn't the losers play with Nancy today?
I should have. I should have arranged to play with you.
Do you play keyboards and guitar?
Yes.
They never thought of it.
I play a lot of different instruments, yeah. I sing.
Yeah, he's like Stevie Wonder.
I play keyboards.
We're
I do guitar.
Backup band.
So my talents are very well featured on the show. All right. So anyway, you have nothing to say, right, drunken lady?
No, I'm leaving town, and I just wanted to say goodbye to everybody.
Where are you going?
How far are you going?
New Hampshire.
And you're not driving, are you?
No, I'm taking a plane.
That's a good idea. You're not flying the plane, I hope.
No.
All right.
Happy St. Patrick's Day to ya.
You guys have any kids? Are you,
Yeah, I have kids.
Nice. You should take your kids away and give them to Nancy Wilson. You're drunk. All right. So you guys decided never to have children? Is that it?
No, we're hoping to have children.
Oh, is it Cameron's problem?
No.
No?
No. I'm kind of, you know, I'm an older girl now.
Right.
Even though I am Supergirl.
Yes.
So anything's possible, especially with a little help from modern technology.
Right. Interesting.
Science. So, yeah, we're hoping.
Well, if you were married to me, you'd have children, believe me. I have incredible.
In fact, Howard is volunteering to be a surrogate mother.
Yeah. No, a surrogate father.
Yeah.
Do you want to get pregnant? Seriously?
Definitely.
All right, well.
I would love to have that.
Go wait in the green room. I'll get you pregnant in one shot.
Outside.
I'm serious. Just say it's Cameron's.
Oh, it'll be like the John situation.
Right. I have a theory that John Kennedy Jr., his father was Peter Lawford. He had an affair with Jackie O. Because he looks like Peter Lawford. He's the only Kennedy kid that's good looking. Think about it.
He does look like Peter Lawford.
That's right.
Uh-oh. Now people are going to start buying
this. Is he kind of like Peter? Is he like Peter Lawford?
So imagine your kids come out looking like Howard Stern. Pretty sad. All right. Anyway, listen. Nancy Wilson, the new CD is live at McCabe's Guitar Shop. Go pick it up. I guess it's in stores right now.
Cheers.
You can see her in Washington, D.C. tonight. No, no, next Tuesday night.
Yeah.
Tonight you could see her in Northampton, Massachusetts at Pearl Street.
Yeah.
Thursday you could see her at Paradise in Boston. Saturday you could see her playing at the Theater of the Living Arts in Philadelphia. And Monday the 22nd playing at the Birchmere in Alexandria, Virginia.
Thank
a lot of plugs.
You for the plug there. Thank you for that plug.
You're on tour, baby.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Is it different playing, you know, doing the solo thing or, you know, having...
Yeah. Well, I did it, you know, a long time ago in coffee. Yeah.
Is your sister pissed that you're not with her?
She's livid.
She's
livid.
Are you wearing a thong right now?
A thong?
Yeah.
I don't wear underpants.
You don't even wear underpants?
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's sexy.
See?
Oh,
it's and just, you thought
you know,
she was
too
uptight.
Much to do. It's
you never
like
wear...
Fussy.
You have to wash, but then you have to wash your pants a lot.
Oh!
Well, no, you just, yeah, you just,
right.
You get like 10 of the same pair of pants that you like to wear.
I understand.
And it's sort of like, that's it.
Interesting. Well, you're adorable.
We learned a lot today.
Yeah.
Now, are you wearing a thong, Eric?
No, I wear underpants because I don't wipe well.
Oh.
I need them. I don't
you,
want my pants.
You don't need to share
okay, is it like the kind of the boxer thing?
No, no, no. I'm wearing very, very small briefs.
Do you do laundry? Do you do Cameron's laundry?
Well, I love to do Cameron's laundry.
Is that right?
Do you find stains in his laundry? Seriously, every guy has stains
what
in his underpants.
What do they call that thing?
You know, Cameron's like this great director and everything, and really a brilliant guy.
Like those tire track things.
Yeah.
They call that. Is that
tracks.
What?
Yeah. Tracks. Skid marks.
Skid marks.
So you do laundry?
Of course.
Really?
I like to do laundry.
And do you inspect his underpants to see what he's doing?
Well,
you do not.
Yeah, once in a while.
Once in a while, you see something, right? Is that
you
a turn off?
That shout and shout it out.
That doesn't turn you off.
To me, it's kind of like. Cute.
It's cute.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, my wife doesn't think that.
Really?
Really?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I don't know what kind of.
My wife knows what I had for lunch.
Oh,
wow. Expect.
She knows the future.
Did you eat turkey again?
Oh.
With carrots.
Oh.
So you see skid marks in Cameron's underwear.
And like, I didn't say that.
Do you ever say to him, oh, big shot director, look at that. You got skid marks in your underpants.
I did not say them. That.
Do you ever humiliate him with it? And say, what are you doing? I mean,
look,
for God's
young
sake,
man.
Look, young man. What are you doing?
You know, I could do that now that you mention it.
But you think skid marks are cute.
Well, you know, yeah, I kind of, but you know.
You're a good woman.
I'm kind of like a motherly type.
Really? That's nice.
Yeah,
I need that.
Yeah,
I need to be taken care of.
Do you?
I sure do.
Well,
I'm very needy.
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you emotional? Are you moody?
Yeah. Yeah, you could say that. That's right.
Do they pay you?
Your seat,
do they pay you a lot of money to be moody? On
what happened when Cameron was making Jerry Maguire? Did Tom Cruise always come over
was
the house?
Was he around?
That annoying putz.
Tom.
What did he try to get you into, Scientology or something? You're not into that, I hope.
No.
Good. Did you laugh at him?
That much. I don't even know that much about it. But
oh,
I mean,
please.
I mean.
Your God's a test tube.
Tom.
Is he very dumb, Tom Cruise? You can say it.
He's one of the smartest people I've
ever
met.
Oh, that's a lie.
Him and Mike Tyson.
No, I'm not.
No way. Him and Mike Tyson.
He is the coolest guy.
Really?
Which is like sick because he's so good looking and he's so talented and he's not only that.
It's show business. Who do you guys hang around with? Do you have any show business friends?
Who are your friends?
Oh, well, you know.
Tom Cruise?
Tom Cruise.
Do you let Renee Zellweger into the house?
Into the house.
Yeah.
It's like, she's out of here.
The way I saw it,
she's
that
gorgeous.
The way they shot that movie and the way Cameron was involved and the way he was talking
about
her.
How about that kiss on the porch?
Yeah.
That was like, woo.
Yeah, I think Cameron was getting caught up in it.
Really?
Yeah, keep him away from her.
Okay.
Honestly.
Well,
I can sense things.
Uh-oh. Although, we have a trust thing. Although, you know, it's funny because he's like, if I get jealous, he gets all excited if I'm
right.
jealous.
Yes.
You know? It's kind of that thing, and like,
ooh.
If I admit that I'm jealous, he loves it, and then he gets jealous, and I'm like, ooh.
Does he ever yell out Renee's name when he's banging you?
Oh!
Renee!
All right, listen, you're a great woman. Nancy Wilson, big fan of yours. And thank you for coming in today. And the new CD, Live at McCabe's Guitar Shop. Great to meet you.
I'm so happy you got to be on the show.
That was fun. And why don't you take a pair of Cameron's soiled underpants and hang them up on the wall of Planet Hollywood.
I'll dedicate those. Framed.
That would be wonderful.
No, I'll send them to you.
Please, and we'll let us take care of them.
We'll know them, surely.
Yeah, we'll launder them. All right, we'll be back right after these words.
U.S. history. See the globe right there.
Really?
May I come in?
Oh, please. I get so lonely when I hear that third attendance bell ring and all my kids are not here.
Sorry I'm late. It's just like this new schedule's totally confusing. Yeah, I know that, dude.
Mr. Spicoli.
That's the name they gave me.
Hey, you're ripping my car.
Yeah. Hey, bud, what's your problem?
No problem at all. I think you know where the front office is.
You dick!
Fedora. Combo crazy and Mr.
Yeah, that's the sound I love. A sweet car stereo.
You're listening. Are you ready?
Two.
Turn up the intelligence.
The Howard Stern Show.
You know, they can't find anyone to host the Tony Awards. I'll do it. I would do it.
Okay.
Why not?
I bet they were bringing a big audience, much bigger than the Rosie O'Donnell.
Yeah.
Audience.
And I'll bring new people.
CBS ought to think about that.
I'll bring young people.
Of course, all the people who would be nominated would leave.
Yeah, I don't think any of the people who would be up for the award would. I think they would all boycott the show. But
now
who cares?
We got a host and we have no one else.
Who cares, though? I mean, it's so boring. I'll just vamp for 2 hours.
Well, we could have a great show. You have a bunch of porn stars as.
I can get Nancy Wilson. She'll perform. I can get her.
Have rock bands play the songs.
I get Jackie's animated joke man.
Give them a show they'll never forget.
Yeah, they'll love it.
People would really think that it was the end of civilization.
Hey, I could get Fred Norris.
Yeah. Please.
I mean, that'd be great. I could do my song to Fred.